Welcome.
Kaboom.
Kaboom.
Say what, Barry?
I don't hear you, Barry. Got to get that unmute. Okay, there you go.
Can we reshoot that three heads in the cloud sequence? I was not really happy with my my haircut there.
I'll have to book the clouds then. It's not easy to get the clouds in advance. You know,
all right.
A lot of people want to use those clouds.
I think you look fine.
I do.
Thank you.
I do. You look almost like me. In that. So that's how.
That's all I can ask for.
That's
really,
honestly. That's all you're gonna get.
You want Safari, Barry?
No, I'm on Firefox.
Oh no! Dad joke. So here we are. It's Steve, Barry, Tom, and the Dawn Patrol bringing you Crash with us. How are we doing? How's your week? Don't answer. It's got to be shitty, right? Your week was shitty, right?
No, it was quick.
Was it?
Yeah, it was very good. Well, doesn't it seem like only 6 days ago that we were doing the show?
Yeah, well, no. Yeah. Seems like 6 days ago that we started this one.
Hey, you know, it's impossible to hum and hold your nose at the same time.
What is that?
You know, it's impossible to hum and hold your nose at the same time.
That's I do know that because I've been working on that for like 15 years.
Try it.
Hum. Wait.
Yeah, let me try.
Steve, give it a try. I'm sure you can do it. Give it a try. Go ahead. Okay.
This is like a Little Rascals film.
This is the stupidest shit ever. Why are we doing this?
Well, a conversation stopper is what
do you have any? Do you have any conversation stoppers?
That was one of them.
What's that?
That was one of them.
That was one of them?
It stopped the conversation.
It started a whole new one.
Through your noses. Anybody who would have seen that really would have thought that we were out of our mind.
Really?
That's what it took, huh?
Really? Yeah. So we got any? I didn't know that was one.
I got one or two. Do you know that ancient Romans used urine to whiten their teeth? you would have thought it would have yellowed their teeth, but it didn't. They used urine to whiten their teeth.
That's fantastic.
That's
isn't it?
Wow, that is a conversation stopper.
Yes, it is. Did you know pigeons can be taught to tell the difference between paintings by Monet and Picasso? In 1995, there was a university study done where they actually trained pigeons to tell the difference between a Picasso and a Monet. And they were able to distinguish it, which probably explains why they like statues so much.
I always knew that about geese, but pigeons, that's really interesting.
Maybe they'll figure a way to teach millennials to be able to do that.
They're much more funny when they're spontaneous.
Wow. Millennials?
Yes.
Oh, no.
Did you know the longest hiccup attack lasted 68 years?
Yeah, the guy finally died from it?
That was where the sentence ended.
Oh wow. Could have had that sentence reduced. 68 year hiccup attack. Okay.
68 years. What else? What else have I got? You know.
Oh no.
Did you know that the wood frog can hold its pee up to 8 months?
Who can?
The wood frog of Alaska can hold its pee Okay, much as a matter of fact, it actually helps it survive.
And it keeps its teeth white.
God, you still beat me to that.
Go ahead, I'll just play some mood music while you keep the conversation stopped.
Let's see. Do you know polar bears have been mating with grizzly?
With Wrigley? Who's Wrigley?
With grizzly. Polar bears are mating with grizzly bears. And now there's a new breed called Pizzlies.
Pizzlies.
Pizzlies. Once again, true. All of these are true. These are not things that I've made up. They're actually they are factual.
And the thin ones are called Oreos.
Factual things. You know, Pez was invented originally to help people quit smoking. And the original Pez dispensers look very much like cigarette lighters.
Yes, they do. They're like this big, right?
Yeah. And now, these days, they still look a little like cigarette lighters.
I use a Pez patch. I'm getting off the Pez.
Yeah, I know. Do you know rabbits can't puke?
They can't, or they're like not allowed to.
No, they can't puke. Their digestive tract only goes in one direction.
How hard have they tried?
Maybe
they could.
I know carrots are binding.
Maybe they could stick a hair down their throat. Get it?
Have any of them seen
hair, like a hair down there? Oh, come on!
Have any of them seen the last X-Men movie?
No.
Okay.
You know, dogs can't blow. Like a candle. A dog can't go.
I don't think dogs have lips, do they?
They do. They have something like lips. Yes.
Do you know cheese is the most shoplifted food in the world?
The most what?
Shoplifted food in the world.
Did you say chap lips? What?
Cheese
is the most
shoplifted food in the world.
Shoplifted.
Oh.
Shoplifted.
Who collects that statistic? Is it like
I think the American Cheese Society.
Yeah.
The AMS.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, that's about it.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
Well,
I think that's more than enough.
That's more than enough. You've stopped so many conversations. Well, we've got fun stuff happening on the show, despite of
that should be our new equivalent sound of the raccoon hello.
Yeah,
I want us to have that picture in the clouds, the three of us.
I want us all. Well, we should urinate first so we can whiten our teeth.
Holding our nose would be appropriate.
Okay, so hey, how about traffic? I was stuck in traffic today. Horrible, horrible traffic on I-95. I just barely got here in time.
Where were you coming from? Where?
Fort Lauderdale Airport.
How long is a trip usually?
A day and a half. It should be 19 minutes. It was more like 32 minutes. So.
Wow.
And I didn't have any time to spare. So, yeah. But it's all about traffic, and it's all about driving in South Florida, in Miami, and we've got exactly the antidote for that. So,
Norb and Marv?
Norb and Marv are here.
Oh, hey, Marv. Look at that. It says three left lanes are going to be closed up ahead.
Oh. A lane ending? Are we in one of the ending lanes?
Should...
No, we're good. Just keep
we're
driving.
Fine. We're fine.
It's good.
We're fine.
There would be
they
a probably sign.
Don't, they don't mean our left lane. They just mean a left lane would be closed.
I've never been in a lane that's closed in my life. Oh, construction ahead.
Oh, that's
probably
what
they
meant.
Why
that's
those lanes are ending.
Lanes are
probably.
Ending, yeah.
There's a lot of work that needs to be done on I-95.
Yep.
Between the hours of 7 p.m. and whenever they end in the morning.
Yep. Yep. All right, well, look, these Bob's Barricade things are coming up, so let me just start to...
Okay.
All right, just one lane is good enough for now.
Yeah.
Yep. Yep. Well, look at that, everybody. Look at all those people. Look at those people lined up. They're lined up. And
bye!
Bye!
Bye! Bye!
It's like,
see you later.
It's like we have our own express lane right here. It's
oh,
like we just
yeah.
bought the express pass
yeah, yeah,
at Universal
yeah.
and we can just pass all those people.
Speed up. Make them feel bad.
Wave at them. Wave at them.
See ya! 74 miles an hour!
Oh, okay. I'm on the cones. I'm on the cones.
Oh, you're on the cones. You're on the cones. You're on the cones.
Okay.
All right. Okay. All right. Good.
I'm one lane over.
Okay.
All right.
We're good. We're good. I'll see you later.
Oh, goodness.
There's a fork coming up. There's a fork. We have to. There's a fork.
I think if we want to exit, we should.
We have to.
I can't. The
we have to get it. We have to get into with them.
We
have to. Why don't they just get into our lane?
Right?
I don't understand that.
All right. Hold on. I know all these people have been making the line, but I'm going to see if I can cut in here.
Yeah.
Right before the exit.
Yeah, you speed all the way. Get all the way to the front, everybody.
Right.
Like Frogger. You were good at Frogger.
I was great at Frogger. And here we are.
There's an opening. There's an opening. There's an opening. The opening closed. The opening closed. The opening's gone.
I'm just going to wait here. I'm going to wait right here. And eventually...
No, it's ending. It's ending. It's ending. It's ending.
Hold on. We're right here. We're here.
Go into the construction opening. Go into the construction opening. Drive into construction.
Let's just go.
It's actually calm in here.
Yeah.
Bye!
Lightning.
Hey.
Oh, Bowie.
We're all here.
Fantastic.
What's that?
That was amazing.
Was it?
No, not really. I was just trying to make you feel good.
I wasn't in it. Doesn't matter to me. Okay. Oh, yeah. Good old Norman Marv. How you doing, Barry, down in this Barry? How you doing?
Good. Yeah. No Miami traffic for me, so that is all good.
Yes, it's always good.
Yeah, got a couch last week.
I got
a new chair this week, so moving up in the world.
You ain't going to be standing up for a long time.
No. No. Laying and sitting is where it's at.
It is not financially feasible for you to stand up any longer.
No. Financially, it makes more sense to sit.
Yeah, you are definitely invested in seatedness. You want to play? What do you want to play?
What were you thinking? I'm thinking either alphabet or by the numbers, whichever.
We can do by the numbers. By the numbers is cool. Yes, guys?
Sure.
Okay. I like numbers.
Okay. You want to explain it?
I'll try to. The way it works is we will all do a scene based on a word, but the rules of the game are that three of us will only get to say between one and five words, and the fourth person gets to say as many as they'd like.
Okay.
I think that explains it.
Okay. Barry Gilbert, I'm thinking of a number. What number am I thinking of?
14.
No, wrong. So you get number two. You're only allowed to say two words at a time in any sentence. Okay, Steve, how about you? What number am I thinking?
One.
Wrong.
We only had a 1 in 4 chance.
You only get to say three words at a time in a sentence.
That's
okay. Barry, what number am I thinking?
One.
You only get to say, let's give you four words.
All right.
Okay. And I, strangely enough, get to say as many words as I want. So, shall we?
Yeah.
Do you have a word?
All I can think of is the fact that Barry's in the safari. So safari.
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 Okay.
Hold on, I'm all messed up here.
That was more than two words. That was clearly more than two words.
I do hate tigers.
Call me Buona.
Sorry about that.
That's three words.
I'm sorry.
Well, so have you been on a safari there, Barry?
I have.
Mm-hmm. Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, sometimes. It kind of smells.
Smells like what?
Yeah, what does it exactly smell like?
One guess.
Okay. Bananas. It smells like bananas most of the time.
Farts.
Elephant farts.
Rhinoceros fecal material.
You know.
Steve, what's with the hat? Does it have any meaning, or is that a...
My head's cold.
Do you enjoy football?
Not overly enjoyed.
Yeah.
I go, that's four.
Really?
You lose.
Well, no, you don't lose. No one loses this game except people watching it.
Not overly much.
Okay.
Tell us about Jets.
Yeah. That was four words, Steve. Tell us about the New York Jets.
Well, they suck.
Okay. Ever been to a Jets game? Anybody?
Been to several.
I haven't been once.
When younger.
You can expand on that.
Much younger.
Okay.
Tell about your childhood.
Grammar much?
Started off young.
Yeah. Didn't end up that way. No, that's what made you choose the safari for your backdrop there, Barry?
Expensive vacation.
It is. Yeah. You know what else is expensive? Couches and chairs. You spent a lot of money on them couches there, Barry? On the couch?
The chair was lazy.
The chair was lazy. Okay.
A lazy boy?
Yeah, a lazy boy.
It reclines?
It does not recline.
Yeah, that sucks.
That does really suck.
But it was cheap.
Really?
How much?
Yeah.
$250.
Yeah,
that's not cheap.
Compared to retail prices.
Oh, you didn't pay retail?
I did not pay.
You didn't pay at all.
Oh, you stole it.
I thrifted it cheaply.
What fabulous grammar.
Are you sitting on one of them now?
I'm not. Don't know why.
What was that?
What word?
Dunno. I'm the sure.
Got that buzzer?
Got it right here.
Use it.
To know if I should. But here's
as soon as possible.
Okay, I'll buzz us out, and we'll go to a commercial.
Don't beat your children. Sue them and take them for all they're worth. You sick and tired of having your children suck you dry of all your time, energy, and money? Punishing your child just not work? Well, not anymore. We brought them into this world, and we think that means you should be entitled to fast cash now.
No one paid you to change dirty diapers or take care of an infant, but they sure as hell should have. Due to a clerical error and more than a handful of legal loopholes, we found out that not suing your child is just plain bad parenting. Kids are the worst, and we think that means they should have to pay for it.
But Jim, my son doesn't have any money. What's suing my child going to do anything for me?
Well, take a listen to these testimonials and I'll tell you why.
Jim Poplawski helped me sue my 14-year-old son. He got me a guitar, an old hoodie, and an Insane Clown Posse CD.
Jim sued my daughter and got me 3 weeks of her allowance. That's almost $45!
Jim Poplawski lost the lawsuit against my son. But for an extra $20, he planted crack cocaine in his school locker. And now, thanks to our local juvenile detention center, I won't have to see him for the next 9 months.
My name's Jim Poplawski, and call now. I'll sue their childhood right out from under them. Your children mean nothing to me.
That's Jim Poplawski's Sue Your Kid Law Firm. That's 1-800-SUE-KIDS. 1-800-783-5437.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the show. And today, we're doing Entenmann's Donuts. Now, the other day, my mom called me, and she says, Lee? And now, you have to understand, whenever my mom calls me, and she starts a sentence with my name, Lee, it's usually she has to tell me something really, really important. So, she calls me up. She goes, Lee? I'm like, yeah, what's up, Mom? She's like, you gotta do the Entenmann's. And I'm like, yeah, I can do the Entenmann's. And she's like, and you gotta smile more. So, here you go, Mom. That's a smile. That's how it works. There you go, Mom. You got the smile. So, let's get to it. We're doing the Entenmann's. All scoring is done in the PTT, which is the packaging, texture, and taste. And all scoring is done on the 1 to 2,000 scale, 2,000 being the highest, and nobody gets a 2,000. So, let's get to it. The Entenmann's were started in 1898 by William Entenmann, and he started on Rogers Avenue in Brooklyn, New York. How do you like that? So, this company is like 120... something years old. You guys know how I am with accounting. It's relatively close, and that's how it is. So about 120 something years old, whatever 1898 minus 2021 is, and that's how it works. So let's get to it. This cookie, this donut, I'm sorry, I'm so used to saying cookies. This donut is like a classic. It's a classic donut. When you look at it, when you see it, when you see this box, you just know it's awesome. Like this box, it shows the frosted donut. Now, it's really important to know this is not a chocolate covered donut. There's no chocolate used in here. This is a frosted donut. So what that means is it's got a lot of ingredients that give it a frosting coating. But when you're a kid, you think this is a chocolate donut. So to me, my whole life, it's been a chocolate donut. And I was kind of bummed out to find out it's not a chocolate donut. It's a frosted donut. So let's get to it. This box. Like that? That's how good I am, right? See, it's better the first time. So this box, I can open up with my eyes closed. I've known this box, like my whole life, I know this box. Like watch this. Look at that, eyes closed. How do you like that? That's the way you do it. That's the way you do it. That's why you open a box without even having to look. So we take out, smells good. Smells really good. So let's get back to it. The glue, all the packaging has decent glue on the side. If you know me, I like a good box with good glue. The glue is pretty good. Came off not too hard. The front was had a little tightness to it. What's pretty cool when you open the lip, more donuts. they show you all the donuts. Even though we only have the chocolate, they're showing us all the donuts. All the donuts. It's like a skirt going up. All the donuts. There it is. All right, so staying focused. Here we go. I like the fact that they give you the clean window in the front so you can see the product inside so you know what you're getting. It's very important to me. Let's get to it. Let's look at our product. Now, when you look at this donut, number one, you can see through it. Everybody knows I like a product you can see through. The fudge stripe has a great hole that you can see through. So this one's got a good hole to see through. It feels nice. Like the texture, it's like smooth. It's like when my little son kisses me on the cheek. It's just genuine. It's nice and smooth. Feels nice. So let's get to it. Smells great. First bite. So let's talk about this. Let's have a good discussion here. So what makes this special is, if you notice, they actually use 2 centimeters of a chocolate frosting on top. Most donuts, you're only going to get like a 1 centimeter frosting, very thin, but this frosting is like a 2 centimeter thick. So what happens is, because it's thicker, you actually feel yourself biting into this donut. So you feel the crunch of the donut, and then you feel the softness of the inner part of the donut, which would be like the cake part. And that makes it awesome. What makes it awesome is you feel yourself crunching through the frosting. And because it's crunchy, the inner cake part is just fantastic. It's like a good combination. It's like eating caramel and cheese popcorn together. It's sweet and salty. It goes together. This chocolate frosting and this cake inside is like the perfect combination. We forgot the crunch. Is there a crunch to this? There's a little crunch. This donut has crunch. It has crack to it. That's unbelievable. Put that in the comment section. Is there any other donut in the world that's got a crunch to it? And if there is, I want to know. So send it to me. It's just great. So let's get to it. It actually tastes better the more you eat it. Because the key is getting the frostiness of the chocolate frosting to coat your whole palate. So your whole palate is covered in this chocolate frosting. And then you eat another piece and the cake part kicks in. And now you really taste the cake part of the donut, which is light and fluffy. So the thick frosting, the light and fluffy of the cake. That's what I'm here for, to help you understand what we're eating. Help break it down. So that's what I got. Let's give it a score. Like I said, everything's done on the 1-2000 scale, everything. Nobody gets a 2000. It's a classic donut. So what are we thinking here? I'm gonna give it a good score. Is it the best donut in the whole world? I don't know. It's up for debate. That's what we're here for. $18.39. Good score. I love the Entenmann's. See you next show.
Gotta love the Entenmann's.
$18.39. That's up there.
For a donut.
Yeah.
Can I stop talking in threes?
Yes, you may. You may stop talking in threes. I'll even get rid of that.
I just realized the first thing I said was 4 words. Not that, though. Oh, only well. I keep it going.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, my only question to Mr. Lee there would be, how many donuts in do you lose your will to live?
I feel like it has to be more than 12. Like 12 and you still have a will. Like you can eat a dozen and still have a will to live, I think.
I do think there was a slight error there. I think he meant millimeters, not centimeters. 2 centimeters is almost an inch. So I don't think that the frosting is 2 centimeters thick. Sorry, Mr. Lee. But we all know that he and numbers just don't really.
Well, I mean, we strive for perfection on this show. So if I were you, I would bring it up to him.
I will bring it up.
And I really thought that it warranted 1841.
Really?
Although I don't know. I kind of like the Entenmann crumb donuts a little better.
Oh, God, no. Really?
Yeah.
To each his own.
They're all good.
I don't know. I'm a fan of the gourmet donut. Like, we have Jupiter Donut up here. And then, I feel like that Voodoo Donuts was the expansion of the gourmet donut, but I feel like they're too corporate now.
Would you consider yourself a donut snob?
I'm a little bit of a donut snob, I'd say.
Well,
just,
you know,
a little.
I try not to think of the Entenmann's chocolate donuts as donuts. I think of them as something else that's really kind of cool. But I don't like give it the mental space in my head of where that I would give a donut.
Yeah, I feel like something prepackaged versus coming out of a glass encasement.
Yeah. Just,
it's different playing fields.
But then I'm a person who likes plain donuts. You know, I like all the others, but I just give me a plain old fashioned. I go to Dunkin' Donuts. I want an old fashioned plain donut.
With a coffee, I'll go plain. But if I'm treating it as a snack, I like disgusting ones. Like load it up with as much crap as possible.
I don't think I ever have donuts without coffee. So I
you know, in Israel, it's legal to bring a bear to the beach.
Bring a what to the beach?
A bear.
A bear to the beach. Okay. Hey, speaking of the beach, that makes me think of weather. Barry, you had some kind of a weather.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Tom, for paying attention to something I say.
What?
I always do. What's your thing?
I thought, you know, we're so fixated on weather forecasts. What's it going to be like tomorrow in my neck of the woods, you know? And I've just been thinking a lot that it seems very selfish, if you will, to kind of focus only on our own weather. And we've got sort of three parts of the country represented here this afternoon. So I thought it would be in the interest of being more inclusive and kind of being a global community of weather consumers that we combine our weather forecasts and just see if it feels more like we're bringing ourselves together. Okay. So I've done a little calculation and I was going to work on a kind of a basis of averages, but I thought it would be more exciting and thrilling, if you will, to be more kind of cumulative. So for tomorrow, the forecast for our three areas is the high is predicted to be 189 degrees. We're expecting slight wind with gusts somewhere between 40 and 173 miles an hour. And there's going to be a 284% chance of rain.
Okay.
So I don't know if that...
This is not an average.
Brings us together from a climate perspective.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how useful it is.
I
don't know either.
It's a so you're adding up all the
I didn't want to shortchange anybody. I mean, this way we don't really know who's high and who's low within each number. We just kind of share the broader number.
And in case some schmucky area of the country is bringing down the average, this overcomes that. And
exactly.
When rain surpasses 100%, I mean, you said over 200%. Is that double rain?
More than double.
84%.
Yeah, it's dropped. It is big.
It means that not only is it guaranteed to rain, but it's guaranteed to 2.5 times rain.
Yeah. It rains on the rain as it's raining.
Yeah, the rain brings other rain down with it. Yeah. And, yeah.
Barry, especially, I have a question.
Even the rain gets wet.
Yeah, exactly. That's it. Like if a raindrop gets hit by two other raindrops, then that's 300% rain.
So it's not quite that wet, but you're on the right track.
It's around 280 something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Steve, did you have a?
Yeah, I had a question, but it could wait until we get through the factual piece of the bit.
Oh no, that ended a long time ago.
Okay. I was just wondering, where do weathermen go for cocktails?
I give up. Where do weathermen go for cocktails?
Get that bell ready, Tom. To isobars.
Isobars. Oh no. Oh wow, he's a conversation stopper even when he's not. Oh wow.
Right. Anyway.
But I did have a question.
I hope I didn't affront anybody with that.
Oh no.
I took him aside to tell him I was taken aback by his affront.
I think this is just about occluded by now.
Yeah. It's low.
Okay, yes. Just a factual question there, Barry, since you got the meteorology thing going. Is it the heat or is it the humidity?
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, who could argue with that?
Tom understands.
I do. Okay. I appreciate that down here in Florida. People say, what's the difference between weather and climate? Weather is what everybody else gets. Climate is what we get in Florida. Pretty much. Yeah.
I didn't know that.
No, yes, that's true. Yeah. I look outside every day and it doesn't even seem like weather. It seems like climate.
Wow.
Yeah.
Something you can sink your teeth into.
You can, like an Entenmann's donut. two centimeters thick.
It's got more chocolate than there is.
Yes, 300% chocolate. 300% chocolate, and that means it's that means it's not. It's Bud. You got one.
It absorbs chocolate from the rest of the world.
Yeah. Yes, it does. It doesn't. Don't we all though?
It's the black hole.
Right. Well, it's time for the news. Time for new old news. But first a commercial.
Looking for an easy way to label everyone? It's new Label Us. Quickly label strangers and friends. Yes, Label Us is fun. And it's so easy to do. Take it with you everywhere. Just who do people think they are anyway? Just think of a handy label, then type it, and apply. You'll feel great. You can even label yourself. That's right. Let everyone see who and what you really are. Why just type when you can stereotype? But be careful. Label-less labels really stick. Remember, it can't be libelous when it's label-less. Label-less. Available everywhere.
It's Eyewitness News time on WTOP with people at a desk. And remember, it's Bullets Day. Bring bullets to work, school, and church to help celebrate National Bullets Day. Decorate your bullets and show everyone you're an American.
I'm Gordon Peterson. Thousands of concerned citizens gathered at the Capitol today to peacefully protest against mandatory seatbelt laws. The group believes that it should be legal to sit in a car any way you choose, no matter how dangerous it might be. Don't try this at home, kids. Try it while Dad is driving. Excited onlookers cheered the brave men who defy the law and common sense to stand up, or kind of sit down, for their sacred rights. In an unrelated story, President Jimmy Carter has been signed by the Washington Bullets basketball team as a point guard.
I've got the moves. my ball skills are out of sight. For Shizzle, I'm finna show out. I ain't gonna lie. I'm nothing but net, girlfriend. Sweet, sweet net. You feel me? Do you feel me?
I thought the White House was white until I heard that. That's white shit, man.
I'm Maureen Bunyan, and I threw up in my mouth a little when I heard that. Meanwhile, will he or won't he? Gordon reports.
Barney Hughes will. We weren't sure. We thought for a while he wouldn't, but he will. He really will. We tried to talk to a smart lawyer, but could only find a dumber one.
He couldn't make up his mind. He said, I probably won't. And I said, Barney, are you sure? Maybe you should. Then he nodded and said, well, I guess I will, dude.
I threw up a little in my mouth again. I should be used to dumb stuff like this by now, and I'm always surprised. I'll grab some Listerine and turn this over to Gordon. Gordon?
You're a woman, Maureen, so maybe you're just pregnant. Here's a woman whose first name is the letter C.
I don't know why it's so hard to get that a person's name can be a letter of the alphabet. I have two older sisters, A and B. They got teased a lot in high school, but I'm fine with it. I have many siblings. I feel sorriest for my brother Z. He moved to England and they call him Zed. You know?
My first and middle names are letters, and I'm a successful inventor of a time machine.
Here's AJ shaking hands with his future self. Speaking of the future, that's NASA's business. Let's see if a girl knows any science stuff.
Couldn't find the Listerine. I have no idea what NASA stands for because, as Gordon says, I'm a girl.
I'll take over here, Maureen. As a guy, I know that these space rockets are way cool. They go... They go a million billion miles an hour, and Jupiter's a planet. It's huge. I want to be a spaceman.
Hey, we give it all we've got. What? Here's Maureen with a follow-up.
Following up, I did find the Listerine. Everything's great. Now, here's Bob with a local mystery.
Sometimes you need a telephone book if you want to use one of these. That's right. A phone. A damn phone.
So they delivered my phone book. Everything seemed normal. I leaf through it and something wasn't right at all.
Tragedy struck this average house on the corner of Yates and Framwall. Barbara Jensen opened her phone book only to find that someone had drawn a line in it. A mysterious blue line. We traced the mystery down to this man. He wouldn't speak to us, so we went away without finding his name or job title. Damn.
Maureen, get out the Listerine. Here's a story you'll hate. Vandals broke into a local middle school and set up row after row of dominoes. They apparently had been drinking. Luckily, the explosive device they had set up failed to detonate. Until this guy showed up.
Now, we have a man who looks like a groundhog. Gordon. I mean, really? He looks like a groundhog.
I know, he's sitting right next to me. You do look like one.
I get that a lot.
Let's ask if he sees a shadow.
I get that a lot, too.
Those are cars.
I know.
in the movie Groundhog Day, a groundhog drove a truck.
Hey, he got killed.
But he was fine.
I saw the movie. I know.
I loved Bill Murray.
Okay. The NBA draft is important, but it's not very well catered, as this guy found out.
Yeah, that's extra crispy wings, half mild, half hot. Okay, wait a second. I'll ask. Hey, do we want ranch or blue cheese dip? Come on, who's buying and who's flying? Come on, people. Not you, cheapskate. I know you didn't bring any cash. All right. Ranch?
This is Bren Glenner again. I mean, Glenn Brenner. I do that a lot. Damn, I threw up a little in my mouth just now. Pass the Listerine, Maureen. I'm told a crowd is gathering outside the studio. demanding my resignation.
I mean, you can't really blame them, Glenn. You're kind of a train wreck.
Gotcha. Yes, you're right. I'm just going to boogie on out of here then.
That's great.
Well, yeah, what a moron. You and I are a good team, though.
Yeah? Yeah?
Yeah.
Wait. Don't ever touch me again.
I guess I'll just do the weather then. Weather, now follow my eyes, is a big concept that can make many people high and some depressed. Now, this looks like a K. I guess that means killer storm. Oh, hello. It's our friend H. I knew a guy whose first name was H. There's more weather, but my marker ran dry. Ah, well. Them's the breaks. Gordon?
Thanks, Bartz. Clive Duvall is a big man in Virginia political circles. Our roving female reporter, Susan King, tells us more.
I spoke to Dr. Duvall to get a sense of what he's all about and whether he'd be a good sperm donor for my wife, Michelle, and me.
I'm Clive goddamn Duvall, Sugar Lips. I run this state. You want an extra towel in your sauna? You don't get one except you go through me. I'm Clive goddamn Duvall, damn it.
I'm going to call Michelle right away. This may be the guy we've been looking for. Watch this space, Maureen. We're done. No time for credits. The crowd's getting ugly. Bye.
I know you're like me. First, you were excited to work from home, but then you started getting stressed out from all of those Zoom meetings. It's stressful. It's tiring. Save yourself from screen exhaustion with Room. Room is fully customizable, including art, books, and even activities. I chose to customize mine with cookbooks, drink books, poetry, and art. For a nominal fee, you can add cat, other cat, or dog. And for only $50 a month, you can add balcony. Treat yourself today. Thanks, Room. Room, explore yours today.
And
good stuff.
I love it when you sneak a little severed arm in the middle of something. One of my favorite genres.
I really enjoyed that Label Us. that was classic.
Yeah, well. Yeah, that's it's Bronco gone wild.
Yeah, indeed.
So, what are your plans for the rest of the day and the week?
Well, I plan to work the rest of the week, and for the rest of today, I'm probably going to juggle and tap dance.
Okay.
Pretty good.
Simultaneously. Speaking of simultaneously, how about Barry's?
Yeah, I interrupted doing my taxes for this show. I just want you to know how important this is to me. So I'm gonna resume taxes.
Oh, resume taxes.
Wow. Yeah, it's the only the one half hour every year that I completely lose my mind and tension level goes through the roof and no one can talk to me.
Yes. Did it. Done it. Yeah. And the fact that, you think it would be easier. 2020, no income. This is going to be easy. Turns out there's still people you have to convince,
Yeah.
Did you use your car for work? Pretty soon I'll be using it for a home.
Yeah, so that's I'm horrible. I'm absolutely horrible.
No, no, no. 3 + 5 is not 8. 3 + 5 is not 8.
Where's that 1099 day I've been looking for?
How about it? How about you, other Barry?
My job is working with taxes currently. Ends the 17th. As soon as the 17th is over, I will be a very happy individual.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well.
But next year is going to be just as bad. The big thing is the stimulus checks and people not knowing what they got. But you don't get taxed on it. So that's good. Yeah.
Well, I know what I'm going to be doing this week. Let's see. Thursday, I always teach a workshop, and Friday is Read My Lips every Friday, 9 p.m. This past Friday was pretty cool, and the Friday before that was even stranger than that. It was fun. It's fun to watch. Saturday is Are You Serious? Every Saturday, we had a fun night last night. It was really, really great. We had bring in new blood and mix it with the old blood. Kind of like the Red Cross.
It's very bloody. Yeah.
Yeah, it's very, very bloody. So check that out. And on Mondays, in fact, tomorrow, Shitty Improv. Fun half hour, actually 34 minutes. Fun 34 minutes. It's always whacked out and zany and funny. That's just what we do.
Tom, how much does Shitty Improv pay to advertise on this show?
By the way.
As much as McLaren.
I can't tell you the amount. I can tell you that it's shitty.
Nice. That's what I would expect.
Yeah. Yeah. Label Us does really cover a lot of our expenses. So.
Yeah.
Now, if you don't mind me throwing a little teaser in, next week I'll let you know who a very famous overphobe is.
Overphobe. Look at it. Don't Google it between now and then. But the famous overphobe is coming next week.
I know I just made it extremely difficult for people to sleep.
It's okay. This show puts me to sleep most nights.
Yeah, yeah. Well, it's fun to see you guys. And we're done for the day. You may go back to your chairs, couches, and taxes, so thanks for being here, and
hey, auf Wiedersehen, baby.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Hasta la vista.
That's even that, which is even better than auf Wiedersehen. See you around, guys.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.